Welcome to your quick bite of cloud engineering. I'm Laura, and today we're here to chat about resource graphs. So what exactly are resource graphs? A resource graph is a type of directed graph, or dgraph, that demonstrates how resources are connected and how they might depend on each other. These graphs indicate how resources you deploy are related. All of the terminology that we use when talking about resource graphs comes from graph theory in mathematics, so it can get a bit confusing when folks are using the terms without necessarily explaining them first. So let's sort those out. First, a graph in this case isn't a drawing, but rather an abstract structure. In fact, it's a data structure in computer science. That's exactly where GraphQL comes from, if you've ever heard that term. We often draw graphs out, like with Pulumi or Terraform's resource graph, as the spatial representation is easier for us to understand, but it can also be represented as a table, like with Azure's resource graph manager. Regardless of how your resource graph is presented, it's always a representation of the abstract structure itself. There are nodes which represent various elements, like resources. They're often drawn as circles, like this. They're also known as vertices or points, depending on who you talk with. In text-only settings like terminals, we often have nodes represented by dots, plus signs, or other singular symbols with text that names the node. Next up, there are edges, which represent connections between resources. Edges on directed graphs have a direction for the relationship between the two nodes. What does that mean? The direction indicates which node depends on another. In a drawing, they're drawn as lines with arrows between the nodes, like this. In text-only settings, edges are often represented by a series of dashes and carrots, with indentation helping to indicate dependencies. So that's great, but what does this have to do with cloud engineering? Well, most infrastructure as code tools create some kind of resource graph and can serve it as output for you to examine. These graphs are great tools for fixing your code when you realize a resource needs to depend on something else, or when your deployment is taking too long because you created dependencies unnecessarily. Graphs from different deployments can be compared to discover how something may have changed, too, when you're exploring changes you didn't make manually. They can help us understand when a system is impossible to deploy, such as for a system with circular dependencies, and how our tools have made sense of those issues when attempting to stand up all of that infrastructure. In short, there are a lot of possible uses for resource graphs in cloud engineering, and it's worth knowing how they work. In fact, in the next Modern Infrastructure video, my colleague David will be walking you through some code on resource graphs, so you don't want to miss it. This has been your quick bite of cloud engineering for this week. If you like this video, please share it. Sharing it and liking and subscribing, of course, helps out our channel and helps me make more videos like this for you. Also, if you want to learn about something specific, leave me a note down in the comments. I do read those, or open an issue in our GitHub repo that I'm linking in the description. I'll be back in just 2 weeks for another quick bite. Take care. Bye. If you have a topic you would love to have us cover here on Pulumi TV, all you have to do is go to github.com/Pulumi/Pulumi TV. Thanks so much.